Respected Dr. Jiten Singh Ji, Minister of State, Independent Charge in the Ministry of Science and Technology, Ministry of Earth Sciences, Ministry of State in the Prime Minister's Office, Minister of State in the Ministry of Personnel, Public Grievances and Pensions, Department of Atomic Energy, Department of Space, Government of India, Sri K.T. Ramarao Garu, Minister for Municipal Administration and Urban Development, Industries, Information Technology, Electronics and Communications, Government of Telangana, Sri Ajay Prakash Sani Ji, Secretary Meiti, who is joining us on virtual conferencing, Sri S.N. Tripathi Ji, Director General, Indian Institute of Public Administration, Sri Rajendra Kumar Ji, the Additional Secretary Meiti, who is also on video conferencing with us, Sri Jayesh Ranjan Ji, Principal Secretary, Information Technology, Government of Telangana, Sri N.B.S. Rajput Ji, the Joint Secretary, DRPG, all award winners of the 2021 National E-Governance Awards, Secretary Justice Sri Barun Mitra Ji, Chairman National Highway Authority of India, Srimati Alka Upadhyay Ji, Additional Secretaries, Joint Secretaries, Senior Officials from Government of India, Attached Officers, Subordinate Officers, Autonomous Bodies like the All India Institute of Medical Sciences, Additional Chief Secretaries, Special Chief Secretaries and Principal Secretaries of Administrative Reforms and Information Technology from 28 states and 9 Union Territory Governments, IT Industry Captains, the delegation from the Prime Minister Office of the Government of Singapore. On behalf of Government of India, I extend a warm and hearty welcome to the Minister of State in the Prime Minister's Office and Minister of State for Personnel, Public Grievances and Pensions, Dr. Jiten Singh Ji, under whose leadership the DRPG has successfully collaborated with Meiti and the Government of Telangana to conduct the 24th National E-Governance Conference at Hyderabad. In the 24-year history of the National E-Governance Conferences, this is the 7th year that Dr. Jiten Singh Ji is inaugurating the National E-Governance Conference. It represents a significant milestone. I extend a warm and hearty welcome to the Minister of Information Technology, Electronics and Communications, Government of Telangana, Sri K.T. Ramarao, for accepting DRPG's invitation to address the inaugural session. I also welcome Ajay Sani Ji, the Distinguished Principal Secretary, IT, Government of Telangana, Sri Jayesh Ranjan Ji, Joint Secretary, DRPG, N.B.S. Rajput Ji, to the inaugural ceremony. Under the visionary leadership of Prime Minister, the e-governance landscape of India has radically changed in scale, scope, and learning paradigms. India has succeeded in transforming technologically obsolete institutions into modern-day digital institutions which benefit millions of Indians. Today, India's rural countryside has changed. Banking correspondents, e-mitras, and common service centers have bridged the gap between the internet poor and the internet rich. As India celebrates its 75th year of independence, as Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, the Honorable Prime Minister has given a clarion call for adoption of next generation reforms by bridging the gap between the government and citizens. This vision of next generation administrative reforms of the Honorable Prime Minister has been diligently translated into reality by the DRPG. In 2021, India's roadmap for next generation administrative reforms witnessed three major initiatives: the successful implementation of the special campaign for disposal of pending matters from October 2nd to October 31st, 2021, the initiative for increasing efficiency in decision making in the Central Secretariat from March to October 21, the Good Governance Week from December 20 to 25, 2021, which witnessed the first nationwide Prashasan Gaon Ki Or campaign, each of which was implemented across on digital platforms across thousands of government institutions. Secretariat reforms, Swachhata campaign, and redressal of public grievances and improving service delivery form the core of India's good governance model. The widespread adoption of e-office has created paperless offices in the Central Secretariat and enabled smooth functioning in the pandemic. In 2021, the CP Grams portal redressed 20 lakh public grievances. Under Dr. Jiten Singh Ji's erudite leadership, each of these reforms were pursued with diligence and commitment. The DRPG implements the award scheme for national awards for e-governance. This scheme is recognized amongst the most competitive and prestigious digital governance award schemes of the country. 2021 witnessed an all-time high of 1,377 registrations, 698 nominations being received on the DRPG portal. Of these, 26 nominations have been shortlisted by a highly accomplished panel of jury members, which I headed and selected after 2 days of presentations. On this occasion, I express my gratitude to all jury members who gave their valuable time to this exercise. Amongst the National E-Governance Awards winners of 2021 are the central government initiatives of Department of Justice, Ministry of Rural Development, Department of School Education, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, and MyGov. Amongst the award winners from state governments are the innovations from Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Telangana, Orissa, Daman and Diu, and Karnataka. The award winners from the districts include nominations from Golpara, Assam, Nagaur, Rajasthan, Dehradun, Uttarakhand, Solan in Himachal Pradesh, Dadra Nagar Haveli, Bandipura and Srinagar in Jammu Kashmir, Indore of Madhya Pradesh, Godda of Jharkhand, and Mon district of Nagaland. In the category of outstanding research by academic institutions, the nominations from the All India Institute of Medical Sciences and IIT Roorkee would be receiving the awards today. The NEGA would also be recognizing the performance of the Indian Oil Corporation and in the category of excellence in emerging technologies. Let me congratulate all award winners who would serve as beacons of excellence for e-governance in the coming years. The National E-Governance Conference brings together practitioners, policymakers, academicians, industry and field officers to collectively deliberate on contemporary challenges of e-governance. The theme is India's Decade, Digital Governance in a Post-Pandemic World. This conference will have 6 plenary sessions and 5 breakout sessions. There is a special session on the Government of Telangana's digital platforms, several of which have been recognized at the national level. TeachIts, Janahita, and Palle Pragati are a few that come to my mind. The advances made by the Government of Telangana, adopting citizen-centric governance models in social welfare and development, and industry and commerce sectors also find mention in the Good Governance Index 2021, released by the Honorable Home Minister of India on December 25, 2021. I am often asked what has changed in India's governance model in the years 2014 to 21. The answer is e-governance has simplified a citizen's interface with government, brought government and citizens closer, and enabled benchmarking of service quality. I have witnessed central government's e-governance models of Ayushman Bharat, Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, Rail Madad, Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana, Umang, Electoral Registration of Officers Network, One Nation, One Ration Card, Passport Seva Kendras, the state government e-governance initiatives like Digital Land of Uttar Pradesh, Khanij Online of Chhattisgarh, Antyodaya Saral of Haryana, GoSwift of Orissa, iStart of Rajasthan, and Maharera of Maharashtra have benefited in bringing transparency and openness to government processes. The organizational reforms have been coupled with significant reforms in personal administration like Mission Karma Yogi, lateral recruitment, accelerated promotion policies, regional conferences for replication of good governance practices, recognizing excellence in public administration by scaling up the scheme of Prime Minister's Awards for Excellence in Public Administration, represent a paradigm shift in India's governance models. New India's strong institutions are best symbolized by adoption of each of these e-governance practices. The best manifestation of maximum governance, minimum government policy is a digitally empowered citizen. As per the precedence of the previous conferences, the 24th National E-Governance Conference would be adopting the Hyderabad Declaration, laying down the roadmap for e-governance for the next year in the valedictory session tomorrow. With these thoughts, I once again welcome Dr. Jiten Singh Ji, Sri K.T. Ramarao Garu, and all the distinguished delegates to the 24th National Conference on E-Governance. Jai Hind.